Welcome to our lecture online. So let's show some examples of the types of variation that we can have. It doesn't have to be linear. It could be quadratic, it could be cubic, it could be square root, it could be all kinds of things. The main difference is that we can either have a direct variation or an inverse variation. If it's direct variation, then the variable will be in the numerator. If it's inverse variation, then the variable will be in the denominator. So those are the two big differences. So let's take a look. Y varies directly with the square of x. So directly means x goes in the numerator and it's x squared, which means as x gets bigger, y gets bigger even faster because y varies as x squared. So each time x changes, you take the new x, you square it, now you have the new value for y. So you can see that y will change very, very quickly. Y varies inversely with the square of x. So now x squared is in the denominator, and notice that as x gets bigger, y gets smaller, so now you have a graph that looks like this. Y varies directly with the square root of x. So here, directly means it's in the numerator, but it's the square root of x, so as x gets bigger, well, y will get bigger as well, but since we're taking the square root, the change in y will not be as big. Here we have y varies inversely as x cubed. So here we say it a little bit differently. But again, inversely means that it goes in the denominator as x is cubed. So we have k over x cubed, and that means that our graph will kind of look like this. And notice as x gets big, since it's cubed, the denominator will get really big, and y will get small really fast. And here our final example, y varies inversely again. That means it's going to go in the denominator, but in this case, with the fourth root of x. So the fourth root of x, and notice that if x gets really big, since you're taking the fourth root of it, that isn't that big of a number, you divide by a smaller number, so y will still decrease with a bigger value for x, but not quite as fast, so the curve will look a little bit different. So you can see there's different kinds of variation. When x varies, y will vary, but it's either direct or inverse variation, and of course you can have x, x cubed, x to the fourth, you can have the fourth root, the third root, all kinds of different ways. And this is not an exhaustive list. There's many more ways. We'll see some more examples of how one variable can vary with the other. And then we'll see some examples in a few videos so you can actually see how this works. And that is how it's done. I think it's right this time. All right.